I'm going to announce the name. Right, the first anchor will be announced last. Okay? First anchor will be announced last. So, and everybody knows your rank. So, you be ready. First felicitation will be of 10 standard. So, when you will see, received with the group, so you can come fast. Okay? This is that row you change. Auspicious land lighting ceremony. Honorable Dr. Subhash Dev sir is enlightening the land. Divya Thakkar, she also is lighting the lamp. Anyway, firstly, honorable principal madam, honorable chief guest of the Subhash Dev sir, मिस्टर मधुकुमार मेहता सर, फॉर्मर प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ रोटरी क्लब ऑफ महाड, टेकडोहा. Also request Honorable Vipindra Patni sir to honor Madhav Bhandari sir, member of Rotary Club, Ked. Principal Mrs. Bhumita Patel Madam to honor Mr. Vipindra Patni sir, Chairman Rotary English Medium School with Go.
Good morning everyone. I take this opportunity to introduce our today's chief guest, Honorable Professor Dr. Subhash Dev sir, the former principal of well-known Gokte Zorekar College, Ratnagiri. Mr. Subhash Dev sir has completed his education in M.Com Costing, MA Economics, M.Phil Marketing, CA, PhD in Education. He has served for 35 years in Gokte Zorekar College, where he was principal for 20 years. He has given precious contribution getting NAC accreditation with A grade to Gokte Zorekar College for 3 consecutive years. He has worked as exam superintendent in Mumbai University for 2 years. He was member of NAC assessment committee for 20 years. He has done assessment of more than 200 colleges throughout the country. He is the one who suggested the involvement of ICT in exam system in Maharashtra. He is serving in the various committees of UGC as well as representative of governor in many universities. Such a versatile personality we have today with us. I welcome you, sir, with my core of heart. It's my privilege to introduce our guest of honor, Mr. Gangaram Shankar Idate sir. Sir is president of Mama Mahajan Smriti Pratishthan and vice president of committee of RSS named Janakalyan Maharashtra Zone. Also, he is vice president of Parshuram Education Society and trustee of Ekta Monthly Magazine, Pune. Mr. Idate sir is advisor of Janata Cooperative Bank, Chipalung branch. He has taken active part in Students Welfare Organization Thane. He has been awarded by Rashtra Bharati Award for Hindi subject and Gora Ranade Best Teacher Award. Welcome, sir. I feel proud to introduce our another guest of honor, Rotarian Nitin Mehta sir. Sir is president of Rotary Club of Mahad. He is also a well-known businessman. Sir is giving huge contribution in social work through the medium of Rotary Club of Mahad. Welcome, sir. Also, we have Professor Mr. Rajendra Mehta sir, upcoming president of Rotary Club of Mahad, as well as Mr. Madhukar Mehta sir, former president of Rotary Club of Mahad. I welcome both of them. Thank you. Now I request Rahul sir to proceed further.
Thank you, sir. Now we will move towards felicitation program of students, those who have achieved remarkable success in 10th and 12th CBSE board exam 2018-19, as well as entrance exams like JEE Mains, BArch and NATA. It's my privilege to announce
highlights of 10th standard result of our school. This year also, our students have given 100% result in 10th standard CBSE board exams. Our first three rankers, Master Bhosle Adwe, Master Selar Gaviraj, and Ms. Yadav Shruti are also first, second, and third in Ratnagiri district with 98%, 97.20%, and 96.80% respectively. Our 18 students have scored above 90% marks. It's the repetition of history that our school every year they are getting 100 out of 100 marks. And this year also in IT subject, 15 students got 100 out of 100 marks, 11 students in Marathi subject, 3 in maths, 1 student in each subject, SST, Sanskrit and drawing have scored 100 out of 100 marks. And one more remarkable thing, that is 52 students have passed with distinction. So I request Honorable Vidyarthi sir to do the honor.
Salope Vishal. Jangam Akshata. भालेकर साही, साळोखे वैष्णवी, पाटील संग्राम, कावित्या संतोष, कावित्या संतोष, आय रिक्वेस्ट ऑनरेबल इदाते सर प्लीज डू द ऑनर. भोळे ओम, भोसले दीक्षा, देवळेकर पायल, वन्स अगेन आय रिक्वेस्ट ऑनरेबल इदाते सर प्लीज डू द ऑनर. राजभर अंजली, बोरकर निधी, तलाठी आसावरे, सावंत साक्षी, महाडिक साही, रेवाळे यश, सावंत आश्लेषा, गायकवाड शिवम, येरापल्ले सनी, पालांडे चिन्मयी, भंडारे अक्षय. आय रिक्वेस्ट ऑनरेबल इदाते सर प्लीज डू द ऑनर. जय वेदा कदम रौनक, युवराज सिंह, थैंक यू सर. आई रिक्वेस्ट रोटरी नितिन मेहता सर टू डू द ऑनर.
आई कॉल अपॉन जावळे पूजा, पाटणे तनया, सिंह अनुषा, मिश्रा सत्यम, पडवेकर सिद्धी, संसारे सोहम, परकार इक्रम, लेंडे अनिरुद्ध, सोहम संसारे सिक्युअर्ड 81.40%. बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर मी. परकार इक्रम, लेंडे अनिरुद्ध, तिसेकर असीम, गुटाला खुशी, तिसेकर असीम सिक्युअर्ड 82.20%. गुटाला खुशी सिक्युअर्ड 82.80%. पंजीरकर यश, भोसले साहिब,
खुशी घोटाला से केवल 82.80% तंजीर करियश सिक्योर 83.20% भोसले शाही थैंक यू सर नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट प्रोफेसर राजेंद्र मेहता सर टू डू द नेक्स्ट ऑनर्स
बोर्डले मधुरा सिक्योर 84.60% जाधव आदिति 85.60% गाडगीळ आदित्य 85.80% बेंखळे हर्ष सिक्युअर्ड 86.20% गिव्ह ह्यूज राऊंड ऑफ अप्लॉज बेंखळे हर्ष शिर्के सम्यक सिक्युअर्ड 87.20% कोटेला अमूल्या 87.80% राजभर दिपाली सिक्युअर्ड 87.80% भवानी दिपेश कुमार सिक्युअर 88.40% हमवीर निशान सिक्युअर्ड 89.80%
भोसले पारस सिक्युअर्ड 91.20% चिखले पवन सिक्युअर्ड 91.40% तांबे निर्भय सिक्युअर्ड 92.40% कुलकर्णी अनिश तांबे निर्भय सिक्युअर्ड 92.40% कुलकर्णी अनिश 94.40% यू बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज अबाउट 90 स्कोर कुलकर्णी अनिश 94.40% रामनस्कर मुक्ताई 94.80% थैंक यू सर
नाउ इट्स टाइम टू फेलिसिटेट अवर मेरिटोरियस स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव स्कोर्ड 100 आउट ऑफ 100 मार्क्स इन पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट्स in CBSE board class 10th exam in the year 2018-19 I request our today's chief guest honorable professor dr subhash dev sir to do the honor kanvelkar varad 100 out of 100 marks in sanskrit 100 out of 100 marks in drawing भोसले श्रेया 100 out of 100 marks in Marathi with 84.80% Pujari Saloni out of marks in Marathi with 85.40% More Arnisha 100 out of 100 marks in Marathi Joshi Purva out of marks in Marathi with 84.80% I request honorable Dev sir please do the honor Shinde Swaranjali out of marks in IT Bhandari Prashant out of marks in IT with 90.20% आंबुले युक्ता आउट ऑफ मार्क्स इन आय टी पवार शर्वरी आउट ऑफ मार्क्स इन मराठी कर्नाश सुयश आउट ऑफ मार्क्स इन आय टी एज वेल एज 92.60% वन्स अगेन आय रिक्वेस्ट ऑनरेबल देव सर टू डू द ऑनर out of marks in IT. Chapris Nehal, 100 out of 100 marks in Marathi and IT with 93.20%. Bondre Sudhanshu, 100 out of 100 marks in Maths as well as IT with 94.60%. Sheikh Sania, 100 out of 100 marks in Marathi as well as IT with 95%. Gavankar Dhanashri, 100 out of 100 marks. Gavankar Dhanashri, 100 out of 100 marks in Marathi as well as IT with 96.60% and 4th rank in the school. Talathi Anvi, 100 out of 100 marks in Marathi, SST and IT with 96.60% and 4th rank in the school. Yadav Shruti, 100 out of 100 marks in Marathi and IT with 96.80% and 3rd rank in Ratnagiri district. Master Shailar Raviraj, 100 out of 100 marks in Marathi, Maths and IT with 97.20% and 2nd rank in Ratnagiri district. And now the first ranker in Ratnagiri district, Master Bhosle Advait Ajit, 100 out of 100 marks in Marathi, Maths and IT with 98%. I request Mr. Subhash Dev sir, please do the honor. Thank you sir, thank you very much.
This is the 5th consecutive year of 100% result in board exam. Class 12 science exam, 100% result this year also. Our first three rankers, Ms. Divya Jadkar, Master S. Sonavne and Master Sarthak Bhavdankar, are also first, second and third in Ratnagiri district with 95%, 94.40% and 90% respectively. And one more big achievement this year, out of 12 students, 8 students have selected in JEE Advanced exam and others secured very good percentile in JEE Mains. So it's not a small thing to give such type of result. And one more important thing for JEE BRH also, all 4 students have secured above 90 percentile. And 5 students have secured good marks in NATA as well. I request Mr. Madhukar Mehta sir to do the honor.
Abdul Rauf Jamada, Siddhesh Kale, Pradnesh Chiprulkar, Manthan Mahajan has secured 92.31% in JEE BRH as well as secured 127 marks out of 200 in NATA.
And he is first in school, ranked first, NATA exam.
मयूर जांगीड, वनश्री वनकर, इंद्रनील अजित जोशी, आनंद कुलकर्णी, पराग गोसावी, आयशा मंडलेकर.
थैंक यू सर. नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट माधव भंडारी सर टू डू द नेक्स्ट ऑनर. प्रतीक नाचनकर, सुधांशु पवार, विराज कदम, विराज कदम secured 82.39% in JEE mains. We get very nice college. And next, Swarali Seth, Sharvari Sethe, Rahul Mehta, Rahul Rajput, Parikshit Pakare, Sayukta Guzar, Rutuja Rapse. I will personally announce because qualified in JEE Advanced with 87.69% in JEE mains, as well as one more achievement, 98.11% in JEE Bihar, and secured 109 marks out of 200 in NATA as well. So all three exams are great achievement. Pawan Bhandari,
sir. Now I request Honorable Gangara Medhati sir, please do the honor. Yash Salvi, Ashray Kandade, Ashray Kandade,
Atharva Ghate, qualified for JEE Advanced with 86.87%.
Shloka Patne,
Abhishek Sawant, Vishaka Akhade, Abhishek Sawant.
विशाखा आखाडे, अमल चौगुले, अमल चौगुले सिक्योर्ड 80.2%, पीयूष पाटोळे सिक्योर्ड 80.20% एंड ऑल्सो सिक्योर्ड 79.21% इन JEE मेन्स. ह्यूज राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज. शादाफ कानेकर सिक्योर्ड 83.60%. थैंक यू सर. नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑनरेबल प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर सुभाष देव सर, प्लीज डू द ऑनर.
चिन्मय वैशंपाय 85.2% and secured 81.28% in JEE mains. Vivek Bankar 85.6%, Maithili Deve 85.8%, Apurva Mehta, Maithili Deve 85.8%. You give big round of applause for her. And expecting good score in NEET as well. Apurva Mehta 86.2%. Apurva Mehta, Surbhi Bandbe secured 86.49% in JEE mains. Naval Kaur 89%. in 12th CBSE board. Give big round of applause for her. Nuresh Baby, 90.2%. Nawal Khot, 89%. Nuren Gaby, 90.2%. Pushkaraj Patel. Next, Pushkaraj Patel. Qualified for J Advance. Okay, if relatives, father or grandfather, please come ahead. Pushkaraj Patel's relatives. Grandfather of Pushkaraj Patel, we are proud to announce his name qualified for J Advance with 98.33%. And students for us in this week as well. Very good achievement in rural area. Saloni Joshi. We are expecting 600 and above marks in NEET exam for her. Then Sarthak Baudankar, third in Ratnagiri district, secured 94% in board exam, qualified for J Advance with 97.93% in JE Mains. Excellent achievement in both board as well as in JE Mains exam. Next, Yash Soname, secured 94.4% and second in Ratnagiri district. He qualified for JE Advance with 93.92% in JE Mains. And the last, Divya Milind Zarkar. Give big round of applause for her. First in Ratnagiri district. Secured 95% in board exams and qualified for JE Advance with 97.60% in JE Mains. And all rounder in all fields, dancing, drawing, painting, everything. All rounder, versatile personality. Thank you, sir.
Now, it's time to honor the students from other schools who have taken admission in our school in 11th standard for next academic year and have secured good percentage in 10th CBSE board exam. I request Honorable Rajendra Mehta sir, please do the honor. Amok Alak Mehta. Amok Alak Mehta. अंबानी पेट्रोकेमिकल विद्यालय नागौर में हर्षवर्धन अरुण यादव उवेश नांदगांवकर रिया सुभाष लांजेकर रुचिता सुरेश मंडपे सरस्वती विद्या मंदिर दापोली सेक्योर 79% सिद्धी शशिकांत कटकरे फ्रॉम सरस्वती विद्या मंदिर दापोली आहन अरिफ अगबानी मृदुला मंगेश बांद्रे अथर्व आशीष कोवळे फ्रॉम सरस्वती विद्या मंदिर दापोली एंड सिक्योर्ड 82.40% Thank you, sir. Now request Rotarian Nitin Mehta sir, please do the honor. Atharva Lakshmikant Pati from Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya Padve Rajapur and secured 85%. Ayub Rafiq Chogule from EMS Indian School Doha secured 86%. Give huge round of applause. अमूल्या सचिन आंबरे Sadhu Vaswani International School, Pune, secured 86.75%. Samruddhi Sushil Kamble from Saraswati Vidya Mandir, Dapoli, and secured 88.20%. Sriraj Ravindra Salvi from Saraswati Vidya Mandir, Dapoli, secured 89.80%. Pratiksha Balasaheb Karad from Saraswati Vidya Mandir, Dapoli, secured 91.40%. Thank you, sir. I would like to call upon Honorable Arjun Jadhav, sir, Treasurer of Rotary Club of Mahad. Please come on the stage, sir. I request our SNC Chairman, Dr. Bosley, sir, please honor Jadhav, sir.
Now it's time to honor devoted all the teachers, the outstanding success of students you have experienced just now behind this. There were lots of efforts taken by all subject teachers. All these teachers have been working here to bring laureates to the schools with full of dedication. We have the teachers from all over the country who are highly qualified, well experienced, as well as devoted to the work. So now it's time to honor these hard-working teachers. I request Honorable Dr. Dev sir to do the honor. First, I would like to call upon here Mr. Rahul Gadpail sir, coordinator, integrator of English department. Next, Mrs. Preeti Nair madam, Mrs. Meera Power madam, Vilas Davde sir, Marathi, sir is speaking Marathi subject, and this year 11 students secured 100 out of 100 marks. Congratulations, sir, for this great achievement. The next, Mrs. Amruta Jadhav madam. Then Mr. Ashutosh Marathe sir, physics faculty. Mr. Vaibhav Nandiskar sir, chemistry faculty. Next, Dr. Prachi Joshi madam, Vaibhav Nandiskar sir, chemistry faculty. Next, Dr. Prachi Joshi madam, biology faculty, MSc PhD. And congratulations madam, this year we will get 600 plus marks in NEET exam. Then next, Swapnil Pandit sir, Mrs. Gwalakar madam, she's teaching social science, and this year also we have 100 out of 100 marks in SST. So give big round of applause for her. Congratulations madam. Mansi Devgarkar, Mrs. Mansi Devgarkar, in this year 100 out of 100 marks. So congratulations madam.
drawing subject. Mrs. Mrunal Mahapati Madam. Math faculty, and this year 100 out of 100 marks in maths. Three students secured 100 out of 100 marks. Congratulations, madam, for this great achievement. Kalpesh Sarkar sir, Mr. Kalpesh Sarkar sir. Mr. Krunal Chavan sir. Physical education teacher. Next, Mr. Santosh Patil sir. Mr. Santosh Patil sir, Information Technology, and this year highest 15 students secured 100 out of 100 marks. Congratulations, sir. Mr. Mahendra Oak sir. Mr. Vinod Kumar Singh sir. Physics faculty. Electronics from MIT Pune. Well experienced faculty, and congratulations sir, this year 95 marks for physics as a topper, and best efforts for JE as well. Congratulations sir. Mr. Rahul Ekagare sir. Bio faculty, MSc Biotechnology from Bangalore. So congratulations sir, this year in NEET exam, very nice score. And Mr. Nitesh Agarwal sir, Math faculty, MTech, NIT Bhopal. And 100 out of 100 marks in 10th exam, and JE qualified all students, and we are expecting JE advanced result from sir. Then Ashutosh Bajpayee sir. Next, Shivam, Mr. Shivam Swami sir, chemistry faculty, B.Tech from JNPU Hyderabad. Congratulations sir for JE result. Mr. Abhishek Kumar Singh. Mr. Purushottam Kumar sir, Bio faculty, MSc Biochemistry, Patna University. Congratulations sir for next upcoming success in NEET exam. Result is not yet announced, but we know the result. More than 600 plus marks. And then Aditya Raman sir, physics faculty, congratulations sir for JE and NEET, both exams, B. Bilal University. Mr. Achitananda Jha sir, chemistry faculty, B.Tech from RTU Rajasthan. And then Mrs. Siddhi Damle madam, librarian. She is playing very crucial role for providing all the reference books to students and managing reading room. We have special reading room in our school, maintaining the atmosphere. So congratulations madam.
As well as I would like to announce the name, Mr. Balasaheb Rao sir, English faculty, MA, MA, as well as BSN. Request honorable there sir, please do the honor. And in this subject, we have 98 marks as a topper, 98 in 10th and 99 in 12th. So give huge round of applause. Thank you sir.
Now it's time to listen our meritorious students
their view. Yukta Amburle is here. Those who have not yet received the honor, please come ahead. Yukta Amburle, some students, now they reach here late because of this remote area, transportation problem. I would request Honorable Dev sir to do the honor. Is anybody here? So by mistake, name is not announced like this. I think there will not be here, sir. Student. Thank you, sir. Now it's time to listen views and experience of meritorious students of class 10 and 12. So, first, I call upon the stage Master Advait Bhosle, who has secured first rank in 10th class.
Good morning, one and all. Muhammad Ali, one of the greatest boxers of all time, had this wonderful quote that struggle now and live the rest of your life as a champion. That was one of the most motivating factor for me throughout this entire journey of 10th standard. Starting in the year 2018-19, the one year went so rapidly, and here we all are with the success and with a large amount of blessings from everyone. Myself, Advait Ajit Bhosle, and I have received 98%. This percentage is not only my success, it is the success of all the Rotary Institute with all the teachers. I would like to tell, especially, I would like to take the names of the each and every teacher. First of all, Pandit sir, then Gaude sir, Rahul sir, Meera ma'am, Preeti ma'am, Oak sir, and as well as the faculty which we had received for the IIT Foundation, all have took great efforts behind us. At any time of the day we would ask them doubts, they would tell us. And I would like to give a special mention that Bhumita Patel ma'am, our principal, she was very much supportive, and this would not be possible without her help. My parents were also very much supportive in this one year. I would like to say my father, he was very much supportive, as well as my mother. Completing all the formalities of thanking, I would like to say that I am here as I have achieved this. I would like to share a very short story with everyone of how a person can achieve anything in life. It is a story of a small village of two children. One was of 10 years old boy and one was of 6 years old boy. Both used to play together very nicely, and while playing at an afternoon, they went near a other village where there was a well, and while playing, that 10 years old boy fell into that well. No one was beside them, and that 6 year boy was shocked. What to do? He was searching everywhere for everything, and what he found was a single rope with a bucket tied. He took that bucket and thrown into the well, and that 10 years boy caught it. And the amazing fact was that the 6 year old small boy pulled up the 10 year old boy with all his efforts, and they both were very much happy. They returned to their village and told everyone about this miracle. All the people started to laugh. It is not possible. How is it possible? There was a person in the village who called all villagers together and told them, the 6-year-old boy was able to do this because there was no one around him to tell him that you cannot do this. That is the main thing that we require to achieve something. That is, we need to have self-confidence. we need to have that environment, and that environment was provided by Rotary Christian School Field itself. Like I would say, all the students of my class, we were like rock bottom, and Rotary was a factory. We went through all the processes of spinning, dyeing, and all the other processes of refining, and finally we have came out as a smooth fiber. That is what I would like to sum up that all Rotary has given to us. Thank you, everyone.
Congratulations once again, Advaik. And next, I would like to call Ms. Divya Sarkar, who has secured first rank in 12th class.
Good morning, one and all. A dream is not that which you see while sleeping. A dream is not that which you see while sleeping. It is something that does not let you to sleep. My mom always taught me to dream big, and my school helped me to walk this path towards my dreams. All over, my JE preparation and my JE journey was a great and amazing one. That was especially because I enjoyed it thoroughly. I also had a great experience at the ICER internship camp at ICER Pune during my class 11th. There were so many ups and downs, hurdles, failures. All these experiences taught me great lessons of exam temperament and also a lot about life. लहरों से डरकर नौका पार नहीं होती, लहरों से डरकर नौका पार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती। The greatest experience that I had and I mostly enjoyed was the struggle to manage my boards and JEE preparation, and I'm greatly thankful to my teachers who helped me achieve this balance and had great faith in me. A teacher is a compass. A teacher is a compass that activates the magnet of curiosity, wisdom, and knowledge in his students. And I was fortunate to have great teachers who have instilled in me the joy of learning and helped me to keep on trying and moving on. I also had a great experience during my class 10 preparation and secured 99.4% in my class 10 board exam with an All India rank of 3rd. And this was due to the dedicated efforts of all my teachers who supported me all through my journey. I joined the school when I was in class 2nd. Over the years, I grew and my school grew with me, expanding its family. My school has always provided me a platform for all my talents. It has brought out the all-rounder in me and helped me to become a better part of myself. May it be academics or skating, may it be drawing or dance, singing or elocution, my school has always tried to provide the best of opportunities for every activity. So I am greatly thankful to all the people who were a part of my journey, my mom, my brother, all my teachers since my playgroup and nursery who have taught me so well till today, and my friends, my school, and everyone who was a part of this great teamwork. I am greatly thankful to all of them. The journey still continues on. So I would like to say that don't worry and fret faint-hearted. Don't worry and fret faint-hearted. The chances have just begun. The best jobs haven't been started. The best jobs haven't been started. The best work hasn't been done. The best work hasn't been done. Thank you.
Congratulations, Divya. And we are expecting result in JEE Advance as well. One more new faculty, Mr. Rohan Kedekar sir, Maths faculty. I would call upon Rohan Kedekar sir. I would request Honorable Dr. Subhash Dev sir to do the honor. Sir, achievement and contribution, best contribution in robotics, national level first robot design award, first rank in Biaj and Nata. In both exams, sir has given best contribution. Thank you, sir. And now it's time to listen the views of parents. And I request Dr. Ajit Bhosle, sir, chairman of Rotary English Medium, SNC chairman of Rotary English Medium School, and parent of Master Advaik Bhosle,
to express his views on this occasion.
आदरणीय व्यासपीठ, व्यासपीठावरील उपस्थित सर्व मान्यवर, व्यासपीठासमोरील सर्व मान्यवर पालक, शिक्षक आणि माझ्या विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, सरांनी आता अनाऊन्स करताना सांगितलं की पालकांनी त्यांचे योग किंवा त्यांचं मत मांडायचं आहे. मी आवर्जून सांगेन की निश्चित हवेत जरी माझा मुलगा असेल तरी मी पूर्ण 68 मुलांचा पालक होतो, पूर्ण 12व्याच्या 40 मुलांचा पालक होतो. आणि त्यामुळे सर्वप्रथम मी सर्व यशस्वी विद्यार्थ्यांचे खूप खूप अभिनंदन, त्यांना खूप खूप शुभेच्छा देतो. आणि त्यांच्या मागे उभ्या असलेल्या पूर्ण स्टाफला, पॅरेंट्सना आणि माझ्या सर्व संचालक मंडळाला त्यांचंही मी अभिनंदन करतो. विशेषतः दादांचं, जोशी डॉक्टरांचं की त्यांचं जे डेडिकेशन आहे ते हे यश आहे. आणि मला वाटतं दादांसाठी आणि सर्व ट्रस्टसाठी एकदा सर्वांनी जोरदार. सांगायचं झालं 10वीच्या बाबतीत सांगायचं झालं तर खरोखर ॲज अ SMC चेअरमन किंवा ॲज अ पालक जे काय आहे ते मला वाटतं आमच्या टीमनीच करून दाखवलंय. भूमिता मॅडम आणि त्यांची पूर्ण जी टीम होती त्यांची अचीवमेंट आहे. फारसं काही आम्हाला बघायला लागलं नाही तर त्या टीमसाठी पुन्हा एकदा सर्वांनी टाळ्या वाजवाव्या, त्यांचं पूर्ण टीमचं अभिनंदन. अद्वैतच्या बाबतीत सांगायचं झालं तर ॲज अ पालक मी निश्चित सांगू इच्छिते की लहानपणापासून त्याला वेगवेगळ्या आवड होत्या. खेळापासून मला वाटतं पहिली दुसरीला त्यांनी योगा केला असेल, तिसरी ते पाचवीपर्यंत त्यांनी चेसमध्ये अगदी विभागीयपर्यंत जाऊन आलेला आहे. त्यानंतर 2-3 वर्षे त्यांनी कॅरम खेळलेला आहे. त्यानंतर शेवटची 2-3 वर्षे त्यांनी बॅडमिंटनमध्ये अचीवमेंट केलेली आहे. आणि हे करत असताना नक्कीच ॲज अ पालक म्हणून मी त्याच्या मागे मार्कांच्या मागे कधी धावलो नाही किंवा नंबरच्या मागे कधी धावलो नाही. एक वेळ आली आणि त्यांनीच ठरवलं की आत्ता एक वेळ आलेली आहे आणि आपण स्कोर करायचं आहे. आणि मला वाटतं ही अचीवमेंट त्याची आणि शाळेची आहे. त्यामुळे मी हे सर्व जे काही श्रेय असेल ते अद्वैत आणि त्याच्या मार्गदर्शक शिक्षकाला देतो. थँक्स अ लॉट टू ऑल द टीचर्स अँड ट्रस्ट, स्पेशली दादा. थँक्यू, थँक्यू.
Thank you very much, sir, for appreciating the efforts of dedicated staff as well as our honorable Mrs. Bhumita Patel madam as a leader of our team. Then I request honorable advocate Mrunal Zadkar madam, parent of Ms. Divya Zadkar, to express her views.
उपस्थित सर्व मान्यवर आणि इथे जमलेले सर्व विद्यार्थी आणि शिक्षक, आजचा हा दिवस कौतुक सोहळा आहे. म्हणजे सगळ्या शिक्षकांचं कौतुक होणं आणि विद्यार्थ्यांचं कौतुक होणं हे खरंच भारावून पाहण्यासाठी मी इथे आले होते. ही शाळा सुरू झाली तेव्हा पहिल्या दिवसापासून ही शाळा मला माहिती होती आणि काहीतरी नवीन करतायत ह्याचा एक खूप आनंद वाटत होता. आज या शाळेचं इतकं मोठं चांगलं स्वरूप पाहून मला खूप आनंद होतो आणि माझी दोन्ही मुलं ह्या शाळेत शिकताना स्वतः खूप मोठी झाली, त्यांना खूप चांगले विचार मिळाले आणि ही जी काही वाढण्याची धडपड होती ती मॅनेजमेंटकडून, शिक्षकांकडून जे काही देत गेले ते सगळे ते खूप भरभरून देत गेले, खूप मुलं हुशार निघाली होती आणि मला ते पाहून खूप खूप आनंद होतो. आज मी फक्त माझीच मुलगी आहे असं कधी पाहत नाही किंवा माझाच मुलगा आहे म्हणून कधी शाळेकडे पाहत नाही. माझ्या मुलीच्या वर्गातल्या सगळ्या मुली सगळी मुलं मी माझीच मुलं पाहते. ते करत असतानाचा अभ्यास, त्यांची होणारी धावपळ धडपड मला सगळं जाणवतं. त्यांनाही कुठेतरी मदत व्हावी असं वाटत असतं. त्यामुळे माझ्या परीने मला जे जे शक्य होईल ते मी सर्व मुलांसाठी करण्याचा प्रयत्न करते. एक पालक म्हणून कधी कधी कोणाला जर काही भावनिक आधार हवा असेल तर तो देण्याचा प्रयत्न करून असं करत असते. पण हे जे आपल्या खेळमध्ये जे काही रोप लागलेला आहे त्याच्या मागे ज्या इच्छा होत्या चांगल्या विपिनदारांची इच्छा होती की खूप चांगली शाळा इथे निघावी, त्याचं जे काही साफल्य मला इथे आज दिसतंय ते पाहून खरंच मलाही खूप 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 आनंद होतोय. आणि ही शाळा खूप मोठी मोठी होत चालली कारण आता माझी मुलगी तर 12वीला आहे. आता 12वीनंतर ती पुढे शिक्षणासाठी पुढच्या वेगळ्या ठिकाणी जाणार आहे. मुलगाही आता 10वीमध्ये आहे. पण ह्यानंतरही मी जेव्हा केव्हा शाळेत परत पाहून ठेवेन तेव्हा मला शाळा खूप मोठी दिसावी एवढंच माझं स्वप्न आहे. आणि शाळेतील प्रत्येक शिक्षक ज्यांनी खूप मेहनतीने माझ्या मुलांवर आणि इतरही मुलांवर सर्व मुलांवर जी काही मेहनती केली आहे जे काही त्यांचे दिवस रात्र त्या मुलांचाच विचार केलेला आहे त्या सगळ्या शिक्षकांना सर्व शिक्षकांना चांगलं आरोग्य लाभावं, चांगलं त्यांना यश लाभावं आणि शाळेला उत्तरोन्नत उन्नती व्हावी एवढीच मी अपेक्षा ठेवते. आणि एवढे बोलून माझे दोन शब्द सांगतो.
सॉरी, एकच गोष्ट सांगायची झालेली आहे की 10वीचा मला वाटतं स्कोर झाल्यानंतर आपण बऱ्याच वेळा विचार करतो की मला कमी मार्क पडले म्हणजे मी पुढे काय करू शकत नाही. मित्रांनो, असं काहीच नसतं. आपल्याकडे कितीतरी उदाहरणं आहेत. त्यातले मी एक उदाहरण मी आत्ता आपल्याला देऊ इच्छितो की शगब काणेकर गेली 2 वर्षापासून आपल्याकडे 12वीसाठी काम करत होती. तिला 10वीला मिळालेले जे जो काही स्कोअर होता तो 65 होता आणि मला वाटतं आत्ताचा 12वीचा स्कोअर आहे तो 84 आहे. आणि तिने खूप मेहनत नीटसाठी पण केली आहे. तर ही अचीवमेंट आपण करू शकतो याचा आपण सर्वांनी विचार करायचा. आणि ज्याला खूप चांगले मार्क मिळाले आहेत यांनी असं समजून जाऊ नये की आपल्याला खूप चांगले मार्क मिळाले म्हणून आपण 12वीला खूप रिलॅक्स व्हावं आणि तसा स्कोअर आपल्याला पुढे मिळेल नाही. मित्रांनो, मेहनत केल्यानंतर कुठली गोष्ट अशक्य नसते. एव्हरीथिंग इज पॉसिबल, जस्ट डेडिकेशन आणि हार्डवर्क गरजेचं आहे. तुम्हाला पुन्हा एकदा भावी आयुष्यासाठी आणि पुढील वाटचालीसाठी शुभेच्छा देतो. थँक्यू.
Thank you, sir. Really, nothing is impossible in this world. Now it's time to listen the views of our today's guest. I would like to request Honorable Professor Rajendra Mehta, sir, to express his views.
All honorary dignitaries on the dais, I will not take much time because I was expected to explain the admission process. That time I was not aware that the students from 12th science are also here, so they know everything. First of all, I will congratulate management committee for such a nice place, very nice atmosphere, and I was much impressed by seeing this hall also. It's very good. First of all, I will congratulate all the students and the heroes of today's program. Those are the teachers. So I appreciate teachers who have taken much hard work for the great success. And especially for JEE admission also, they are taking much effort. You know Praveen Dawade. I will tell only one small example. What he tells is, a bird has two wings. So study is one wing and exercise is another wing. Without, he cannot fly. So try both the ways. Your health should be good as well as your study should be good. Other thing I will tell as a Rotary member, tree plantation. I think yoga classes you are running. Am I right? So that is very good. But every student should plant a tree and take care of that tree for till he goes to 10th or 12th. I am sure all the students will stand in competition, there is no doubt. And for them, I will congratulate and give my best of luck for their future. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for your appreciation. Now, I would request a guest of honor, Honorable Mr. Rotarian Nitin Mehta, sir, to say a few words.
Good morning, good evening. विद्यार्थ्यांचं अभिनंदन त्यांनी ज्या मार्क मिळवले म्हणजे मला असं वाटतं की माझ्याकडे आमच्या दोघांची आमच्या पेरेंट्सची आमच्या दोघांची पेरेंट प्रत्येक विद्यार्थ्याला एकेका जाईल म्हणजे आमचे पण 90% दोघांचं मिळून एकेकाचीच 95% होते म्हणजे खरोखर तुमचं कौतुक करावं तेवढं कमी आहे आणि भरपूर शिका आणि रोटरीमध्ये जाणारा रोटरी स्कूलमध्ये शिकणारा माणूस हा जगाच्या नाही पाठी कुठल्याही जाऊ दे कॉम्पिटिशनमध्ये हा पुढेच राहणार आणि त्याला कुठेही लंबी तर जास्त आणि अजून तुम्हाला एक सांगेल की तुम्ही आता जास्तीत जास्त मेडिकल लाईफ बघा मेडिकल त्या वेळेला म्हणजे तेजीमध्ये आला प्रकार नाही आहे तुम्ही इंजिनिअरिंगचा उपयोग केला तुम्हाला थोडासा तेजीमध्ये हा प्रकार दाखवतो पण तुम्ही मेडिकलमध्ये गेला तर त्याला नवीन नवीन असं तर हे नाही आहे तुम्ही बिझनेसकडे जा म्हणजे इंजिनिअरिंगमध्ये पण बिझनेस आहेत भरपूर त्यात पण तुम्ही टॉपरलाच पाहिजे आणि जो रोटरी स्कूलला आहे तो टॉपरलाच राहील कुठेही जा तुम्ही रोटरी स्कूलचे तुम्ही नाव हे कराल तुम्हाला तुमच्या आयुष्यासाठी ऑल द बेस्ट
Thank you, sir, for your kind guidance. I request honorable guest of honor, Mr. Gangaram Hidake, sir, to guide us on this occasion.
Sanmananiya Vyaspeeth. आजच्या कार्यक्रमाचे प्रमुख अतिथी देव सर या संस्थेचे अध्यक्ष गोपिंददादा पाटणे आणि इतर मंडळी आणि आपण इथं जमलेले सगळे विद्यार्थी आणि पालक आणि शिक्षक बनवले मला पहिल्यांदा या शाळेचा किंवा या संस्थेचा एक फार मोठा विशेष कार्यक्रमाचा आवडला तो म्हणजे विद्यार्थ्यांचं कौतुक तर दरवर्षी होतच राहतं कोण ना कोणतरी बोर्डात येतं नंगलात येतं मास्क मिळतात ते दरवर्षी हा कार्यक्रम असतो मी एका संस्थेचा उपाध्यक्ष आहे मोठी संस्था माझी 5-7 हायस्कूल्स आहेत मालिकूस आहे प्राथमिक शाळा आहे इंग्लिश मिडियम आहे पण ज्या शिक्षकांनी परिश्रम केलं त्या शिक्षकांचा सत्कार हे मला एक अतिशय नवीन विषय माझ्यासाठी कारण मरेन मरेच तू मरत असतो तो शिक्षक मी 35 वर्ष शिक्षक म्हणून काम केलेलं आहे त्या शिक्षकाला घडवताना काय काय घडवावं लागतं आणि काय काय सहन करावं लागतं हे सगळं माहिती असल्यामुळे आज आपल्या शिक्षकांचा जो सत्कार झाला त्याबद्दल मी संस्थेचे खरोखर अतिशय अभिनंदन करतो आणि त्याने हा एक फायदा घातला आमच्या सरकारला नवीन लोकांना मिळाला पाहिला सगळीकडे आपसुरू करण्याचा प्रयत्न ही शाळा ज्यावेळी सुरू झाली त्या वेळेपासून या शाळेबद्दल मला अतिशय प्रेम आणि अभिमान आहे त्याच कारण म्हणजे या संस्थेचे अध्यक्ष बिपिनदादा पाटणे त्यांचं आणि माझं शिक्षण एकाच गुरुकडे झालेलं आहे पण एक काळ मी त्यांचा गुरु होतो हे सांगायला अभिमान अशासाठी वाटतो की सगळ्याच विद्यार्थ्यांच्या बद्दल असं म्हणायला मिळत नाही आज मला चान्स मिळाला की एका चांगल्या विद्यार्थ्याचा मी शिक्षक आहे आणि म्हणून मुद्दा नाही आणि म्हणून बिपिन दादांची शाळा म्हणजे आपलीच शाळा एका संस्थेतही आम्ही दोघे काम करतो मगाशी चुकून त्यांचा पद मला लावलं गेलं ते आहेत त्या संस्थेचे अध्यक्ष आणि मी आहे कार्यवाह मामा माझे स्मृती प्रतिष्ठा ते अध्यक्ष आहे मी त्यांच्या अंडर काम करतो असे आमचे पहिल्यापासूनची स्थिती आहे मुलांना जाता जाता सांगेन तुम्हाला असं की हे तर शिक्षण होत राहतं, आपण मोठे होत राहतो, धंदा उद्योग करतो, नोकऱ्या करतो, पण एक गोष्ट लक्षात ठेवा, आपल्या आईला कधी विसरू नका. मग स्वतःची आई कसे आहे, स्वतःचे वडील आहेत, स्वतःचं कुटुंब आहे, तशी शाळा ही सुद्धा किंवा संस्था ही सुद्धा आपली आई. आणि ज्यावेळी गेलेली मुलं परत शाळेत येतात आणि होय सर तुम्ही मला शिकवलं म्हणून मी एवढा मोठा झालो हे ऐकण्यात जो आम्हा शिक्षकांना आनंद असतो ना, याच्यासारखा दुसरा कुठलाही सत्कार असतो. आपण जोडलं गेलो पाहिजे. इतरा महिन्यामध्ये एक ओळ म्हटलेले गाण्याच आहे, ते मी काही सगळं सांगत नाही, वेळ कमी आहे. दोन ओंड त्यांची होते सागरात भेट, एक लाट तोडी दोघा पुन्हा नाही गाठ. हे ओंडक्यांसाठी आहे, माणसांसाठी नाही. ओंडके ठीक आहे, जातात एकमेकाला, पण आपण माणसं आहोत, आपण ठरवतो की मला या शाळेत यायचंच आहे. आपण ठरवलं तर या शाळेला भेट देतो. आम्हा सगळ्या संस्था चालकांचं एक दुःख आहे की एवढ्या मुलांचं ती मध्ये मध्ये असतो म्हणतो, शिक्षकांचं दुःख आहे, पण ही मुलं मोठी झाली की सगळी चित्र येतात असं नाही हो. मग त्यांना त्या भिंती दिसत नाहीत, त्यांना ते आठवत नाही, ते आठवले पाहिजे. म्हणून हे ऋण कधी विसरू नका. त्याचबरोबर या संस्थेचं जे वातावरण आहे ते मुलांना खरोखर अन्य ठिकाणी पाहायला मिळत नाही. शिक्षकांचं, संस्था चालकांचं, एखाद्या संस्थेचा एखादा अध्यक्ष आला की काय स्टाईल असते मी अनुभवले अनेक ठिकाणी. 35 वर्ष शिक्षक होतो, अनेक संस्थांचे संबंध आहे शैक्षणिक. तर आले होते कोणते पुढे येणार, मग साहेब 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 असं करणार, मग साहेब पुढे जाणार. आज मी काय पाहिलं जे मला भावलं, मी पाहिलंय की दादाने मी एकत्र आलो, दादा कुणाच्या तरी पाठीत थपाटा घालताय, काय रे बरायच ना कुणातरी मुलीला चौकशी करताय. हे जे नातं आहे ना, हे नातं शिक्षक टिकवतात, पण संस्था चालकांनी टिकवणं हे ज्या संस्थेत घडतं ती संस्था काहीतरी रचनात्मक काम करते हे लक्षात घ्या. जाता जाता शेवटचं फक्त एक उदाहरण त्यावर सांगून थांबतो. आता बिपिन दादा म्हणाले भरपूर बोलले सर, त्याचा मला धाक असतो त्यांचा, म्हणून अगदी नेमकं तुम्हाला आवश्यक आहे तुम्ही काय केलं पाहिजे म्हणून एक मुद्दा सांगतो. आपल्या सगळ्यांना माहिती आहे की व्हिएतनाम नावाचा एक छोटासा देश आहे आणि ह्या व्हिएतनामचा आणि अमेरिकेचं युद्ध चालू होतं, त्याला कोल्ड वॉर म्हणतात, शीतयुद्ध. किती वर्ष चालू होतं? 20 वर्ष. आणि जगाच्या पाठीवर एवढा श्रेष्ठ असणारा हा अमेरिका त्याला ह्या व्हिएतनामने हरवलं. छोटासा देश. आणि हे सगळं झाल्यानंतर जगातले काही पत्रकार त्या देशाच्या मुख्याला भेटायला गेले, प्रमुखाला. काय म्हटलं तुम्ही असं काय केलं की ज्यामुळे एवढा मोठा बलाढ्य अमेरिका तुमच्या पुढे हतबल झाला? त्यांनी जे उदाहरण सांगितलंय ते आपली सगळ्यांची छाती अभिमानाने भरावी असं ते उदाहरण आहे. त्यांनी सांगितलं की आम्ही दुसरं काही नाही केलं, आम्ही एका राजाचा अभ्यास केला आणि त्या राजाचा अभ्यास केल्यानंतर आमच्या लक्षात आलं की हे जे त्याचं तंत्र आहे त्या तंत्राने आपण गेलो तर ह्या अमेरिकेला हटवू. आणि म्हणून ते तंत्र होतं, सांगा आपल्या सगळ्यांना माहिती असेल, शिवाजी महाराजांचं तंत्र कुठलं होतं? त्या तंत्राने म्हटलं आम्ही हरवलं. म्हणजे काय झालं? तर म्हटले ते तंत्र आम्ही गंदिमी कावा याने यांना आम्ही हरवलं. आणि त्यांचा इतका प्रचंड विश्वास ह्या देशातल्या छत्रपती शिवाजी महाराजांचा, ज्यावेळी त्या प्रमुखाचा मृत्यू झाला त्यावेळी त्याने आपल्या मृत्यूपत्रात लिहिलं होतं की माझ्या मृत्यूनंतर माझ्या समाधीवर हे लिहा. काय लिहिलं होतं? की या ठिकाणी छत्रपती शिवाजी महाराजांचा एक मावळा चिरनिद्रा घेत आहे. देशाचं नाव मोठं करण्यासाठी झटलं पाहिजे. ही गोष्ट इथेच नाही थांबली, ते गेले काही वर्षांनी व्हिएतनामच्या परराष्ट्र मंत्री होत्या एक महिला, त्या दिल्लीत आल्या. आल्यानंतर नेहमीच्या पद्धतीने त्यांची उठाठेव सगळं करायचं झालं. आणि सगळ्यांच्या समाधान झाल्या. बाकी सगळे लाल किल्ला दाखवताना अमुक सगळ्या आलं. त्यांनी विचारलं, अहो मला जे पाहिजे ते दाखवा काय. तर छत्रपती शिवाजी महाराजांच्या समाधीची मला दर्शन घ्यायचं. म्हणलं ते इथं कुठं आहे, ते असेल तिथं मला जायचं आहे. आता गेले घेऊन दुसऱ्या दिवशी तिथे समाधीकडे. समाधीकडे घेऊन गेल्यानंतर त्या विदेश मंत्र्या बाईने अर्धा तास त्या मांडी घालून बसली, ध्यानस्थ बसली, नमस्कार केला आणि आपल्या पेईला सांगितले तयारी होती सगळी. एक पांढरं वस्त्र आणायला सांगितलं आणि तिने अशी त्यांनी खवखवीत माती त्या आपल्या पांढऱ्या वस्त्रात घेतली आणि निघाली. पत्रकारांनी विचारलं, हे काय तुम्ही घेतलं माती कशासाठी? म्हटले नुसती माती नाही, त्या मातीसाठी विशेष असलेली संदूक पण घेऊन आले आणि त्याच्यामध्ये घेऊन ते निघाले. काय सांगितलं त्याने उत्तर, की या देशाचा हा जो पराक्रमी राजा आहे त्याची जी ही माती आहे ती आम्हाला अतिशय प्रेरणादायी आहे, पुण्यदायी आहे. ही माती आम्ही विमानातून आमच्या देशाच्या कानाकोपऱ्यात टाकणार आणि देशातल्या सगळ्या नवयुवकांना आणि जगाला संदेश देणार की आम्हाला ह्या छत्रपती शिवाजी महाराजांची प्रेरणा मिळाली आहे आणि म्हणून आमचा देश एवढा प्रगतीपथावर आहे. सगळे नागरिक आहोत आणि म्हणून देशभक्ती, शिस्त, प्रेम, आपल्याबद्दल आपुलकी हे सगळे भाव शिक्षक शिकता शिकता आपण आपल्याजवळ जोपासले पाहिजेत असं मला वाटतं. आपण थोडंसं लांबलेलं माझं भाषण ऐकलं, इथेच थांबतो. धन्यवाद.
थँक यू सर फॉर युअर काइंड गायडन्स. नाऊ इट्स टाइम to listen and you all are eager to listen. I request honorable chief guest Dr. Subhash Dev sir to address the function.
Dignitaries, the dais, and all the students and the teaching faculty of the school. Normally I attend these types of so many functions in the last so many years. Today I am very much happy within you that we have not only achieved the 100% result for the 1 year, 2 years, but it is consecutively for 8 years. For last more than 3 decades, I am working in the field of education. And my working is not only in the field of higher education, degree and postgraduate, college level and university level, but I am working for pre-primary level. And my research interest and so on. Fortunately, I have traveled regularly throughout the country and abroad also. And in some places I see the oasis of quality in the field of education. And I miss this very near oasis for so many years. Because between chief was inviting me a number of times, but every time I say I am busy, I am outside, I have some reappointment and so on. But today, finally, I reach here. First of all, I would like to share what I like. And naturally, then I will suggest what you should do more. What is the future challenges of education for students, teachers and the management also? First, I started with Advaitin Jadhkar. After a number of years, I have seen the toppers are speaking fluently. And then both are speaking in the English. So Dr. Bhosle, can I say credit also go to you? And Advocate Mr. Jadhkar and my good friend, Advocate Milind Jadhavkar. I know he is a how we talk for a number of years and so on. Otherwise, what happened? For so many years, I have seen those who are toppers in the 10th and 12th, in state exam or CBSE boards or any other national boards. Most of the time, they work hard throughout the year. They write the good answer books, they get the good marks, out of out marks. But if someone say that now explain in the 5 minutes how you work for the last year, then there is a problem of vocabulary, then there is a problem of stage bearing, then there is a problem of continuous speaking on the one particular subject. But when your students, those who are top students, if they are good speaker, and I will not say they are a good orator till now, they are good speakers only. I differentiate in these two terms, good speakers and the orators. It means for the last 10 years, all Madam Nibu and your colleagues, they have not only concentrated on academics, but also on the all dimension development of the student. And that is a very good thing. No doubt, as a teacher, I always like the marks and percentage. But unfortunately, I don't like only percentage. I like the good physique. I like the good health. I like good participation in number of extracurricular and co-curricular activities. And doctor, when you say that you are always changing the games, indoor games, he is also fit, I think, participate outside, outdoor games also. And now you allowed him. Now you have done the everything. Is sufficiently matured. So these types of all-around development, this is the one sign of the good school. Because what is the difference between the schooling in this country and the other countries? Especially I am talking about the advanced world. Maybe USA, maybe Western Europe, maybe Australia. Even now we can say in the Japan, New Zealand, Indonesia and so on. In their schools, they don't have the curriculum and evaluation like ours. Because we have something, element of compulsory everywhere. Basically, in the advanced countries, students are allowed to work. Their curriculum is not restricted to that particular semester or for that year. If someone is good in the mathematics and in the first standard, he wants to clear the third standard exam of mathematics, he is allowed. And another side of this method is someone is weak in the drawing. And even in the fourth standard, he may not have cleared the second year drawing. He is allowed to do that also. And being a limited number of students, because the population is very limited in the most of the advanced countries, students are allowed to do a semester job in a month or in the week, and accordingly he was promoted. And at the end of the year, they don't have the result like us, pass or fail. They only declare whether he is eligible in which subject, he is not eligible in which subject. You want to go in the second standard, fine. If you want to stay in the first standard, it is also fine. So their system is very different. And take it from me, the whole world feels the Indian schooling system up to 10th is at present one of the best system, with subject to some corrections. If teachers, students and parents, they work together as a team, like you, then it is the best system. Unfortunately, in this country, in the schooling system, what happens, you know? Teachers, they are not committed teachers. Rather, why they are teachers, they don't know, sometimes up to the retirement also, especially in the government schools, where they get the maximum salary from the government. And from government they are getting the salary means what? This salary is paid from the very poor people of this country. Those who pay regularly the taxes, That is the income of government. And government gives the salary and other things, other perks to these types of employees. What is the position in this kind of this schooling or school education? Presently, the whole picture is a very different. This type of committed teachers, committed management, committed principal man, and the most important, committed students. Because when the students, they were coming for the to take the prize, I was only interested to know and to observe their body language, how they behave, how they receive the prize, how they move from the dais, how they come to the dais. All these things give us a lot of information, how they spend the 10 years or 12 years in the schools, including the junior year or plus 2 year. So dear students, I feel in this school you get the marks, that is a good thing. But remember, you get a lot of things which is not written on your mark list. Or it will be not written by the board even on your certificate of 10th or 12th. That you have learned, that you get directly from your faculties, that you get indirectly from the school, from your friends and so on. That is more important. Sometimes someone was speaking here that we are the human. What is the difference between other animals and human? Even if you don't want to learn, human learns. Why? The answer is one word, one sentence, because he is a human. So even when we say, well, I don't want to learn this, still I learned a lot of things. Especially in the schooling days. These are the years of investment in the learnings. One way you get the certificates and mark list and all these things where you move upwards in this education system and so on, that is one way of learning. But more than that, what you learn informally, that is more important, I'm sure. Because when coming in, I have seen your school progress on the computer there, in your computer lab. Lot of type of participation, even once student, myself and Gangavadi sir, we discuss, he must be a sportsman, was initiated here. So participation in the sports, participation in the cultural activities, participation in the extracurricular other activities, competitive exams, that is a more important and so on. Because tomorrow's world, where you have to work, say from next 2 decades or 3 decades, where you have to work very actively, maybe here, maybe abroad, anywhere. Because in the era of globalization, whether you work here or whether you work in the US or whether you go for Australia, it is immaterial. But one thing is sure, that you have to work in the competitive society. And for that competitive society, what you need? I will give you one concrete example. When Dr. Bhosle becomes a doctor, his option for that CBZ only, chemistry, physics and biology. Am I right? Because I am a doctor, but I am a doctor of different type. I am not a doctor from medicine. But his choice was CBZ. Means there was no mathematics, no specialization in mathematics in this season. Rather, those students of my generation, they go for the medicine because they don't want to work in the mathematics. So they prefer the life science field. But whether this is possible for next generation, for your generation? No. Because now the practice of medicine, practice of doctor is becoming more and more techno-based. You have to use a lot of equipments. You have to use the IT. Now the robotic operations is becoming the common.
So doctor must know the robotic technology. In other words, suppose tomorrow civil engineer. He must know the EPS and other types of techniques. The descriptions of the various jobs are changing from general level to the super speciality level. And dear friends, your career is not in the general category. You will not be only doctor. You will not be only engineer. And experts in the one field may not be useful in the future. See, even in the, suppose the earlier last 10 years, someone was IT engineer, then there is a very easy job available. You work 2-3 years in India, maybe at Hyderabad or Bangalore or at Pune, then you go to the US. Now what is the position of IT engineer at present? It is a very awkward situation. Now you have to go for super specialization, not only the specialization. Even in the medical also. Now, I remember earlier it was only MBBS that was sufficient for practice. Then it was MDMS. Now, after MDMS, you have to go for super specialization. Means after 12, you have to spend not less than 10 to 12 years in the highly competitive education system, then you will become the doctor. And whether you will become the successful doctor or not, that will be decided by the masses after the next 5 years. So at the age of 35, you will test the success or otherwise. This is because of the competitive society and so on. So in this era, now you are going for some further education, especially of those who have cleared the 12th and those who are in the 12th. What things you have to decide personally, I feel. One thing, don't go with the routine way. Number of people go by this way and that normal way become the highway. My suggestion, in the competitive society, don't follow that. For example, for the engineering, nearly 365 specialized trades are available. But you ask any engineer also, he or she will give 10 to 15 trades only. What about the others? So try to find out what are the others. So don't follow the routine way. Because it is always easy to travel on the national highways. But to go to the rural area and develop the new small way is always difficult and it is not the common also. And you to follow, I remember one great story of great Gyanendra Narvekar. He has written in his autobiography. And he said that number of students passed the inter science. At that time there was no 12. It was a 4-year degree and he is a student of Banaras Hindu University because his father was professor there of mathematics. So he said that number of students in the inter science. And his father was a great physics teacher and mathematics teacher. So lot of the colleagues and the relatives of the Narvekar, they were expect that young Narvekar was an intelligent student. So naturally he will go for engineering. But he decided that I will go for pure science. Then most of the people in the Banaras Hindu University, colleagues of his father, relatives, those who don't know even the difference between the engineering and pure science, they blame it that you are the fool. Every opportunity for you to go for the engineering, your father is here in a very dominant position in the university. What you need, what every type of the educational guidance is there. What is father saying? No. Where you want to go, he says, sir, he asks his father, I want to go for the physics. And after physics, I will concentrate my study in the astronomy. for this purpose I will go to the Cambridge. For the same. And now after so many years, he says, he has written in his autobiography, good number of my friends who are the, at that time, clever like me, intelligent like me, they have joined the medical and engineering profession. They earn the monies, they have constructed good bungalows nearby Banaras area. They earn the huge money also. But they are known to very restricted group of the people. Doctors are known by the patients only. And engineers are known by the employers only. This is not my quotation. This is Narendra's quotation. But he said, now, wherever I go throughout the world, Ayur Narayakar effect is known by every astronomist. This is the difference. Rather, this is the difference to be a clever and to be an intelligent. I think your score, your marks in the 10th and 12th is one of the tests for your self-evaluation, whether you are clever or whether you are intelligent. If you are clever and if you are hard worker, you can score out of top marks. But you are intelligent, then you will score out of out, but you will learn the subject also out of out. Now you decide yourself, out of out marks, number of good numbers of students have gained, earned in this exam. What about the knowledge of the subject? It is also out of out, it is a very good. If it is not out of out, this is the stage to find out where you are lagging. Suppose you score 100 mark in IT, but as per your opinion, your IT knowledge is 85%. Then he has a lot of time to find out where this 15% knowledge is missing. Further educational life needs more concentration on knowledge than the marks. Because a good student like you, marks will come automatically. But you have to concentrate on the knowledge of the subject. Because reason is very simple. In the great Mahabharata, you must know that story, Arjuna and that words, that story is known to everyone. But one of the meaning of that story, one student asked, why only Arjuna concentrated? The great fellow teacher says, because he concentrated, because he is Arjuna and others are others. This is the difference. Now you decide whether you are here Arjuna or you are in the others category. If you are others category, best luck. If you are Arjuna, you have to go for hard work more. And more hard work will give you more and more knowledge, and at a specific level, it will give you the more satisfaction. Other material things, that money, car and everything, that will come automatically. Forget about it. Don't you have to concentrate. Because that is the job of those who score little bit less, those who are hard workers, they will concentrate on that thing. That is also not wrong, remember. But you are really genuine. Then convince yourself that I am the intelligent, I am not the clever. And once you convince this, then you will find the whole world with a different eye shade. Eyes are same, but you will view it in a very different way. And that is an expectation by you, maybe from your parents, maybe from your teachers, but most important what Siddhartha sir says, from the society. Very recently, I visited that Satish Dhawan Space Center, where all most of the satellites and space shuttle moves in the space. I was there for the whole one day. I have interactions with the faculty there and the researchers and so on. While moving in the various campuses there, they have separate buildings for the separate activities. one fine thing I observed, not of the any single cabin, there is not a single name of Marathi Muslim. Then, after while taking the leave, we have very nice interactions with the director, and I asked him, why you don't take the Marathi students? They told me, sir, for this you people are responsible. You, your schools, your colleges, they never tell the students that space science is upcoming branch of the knowledge. Dear students, there you will find the scientists from so-called, what we say, not the good states, and in the Hindi we say Bimaru states. Lot of people, lot of scientists from this type of the shape, you will form the Sharma, Varma and all these things. But not a single Patil, Bhosle. Because Patil and Bhosle doesn't know which is the upcoming area of the knowledge. That is the space science. In next 2 decades, when we will travel to the moon regularly, how many space scientists we will need? As a country, we must have the dream that we will compete with the NASA then. Not we will participate only in the NASA exams. And day will come, Indian Space Research Organization will conduct the exam in the USA school. And they will say that we have participated in Indian Space Research Organization school exam. This should be the dream of the country. Dreams will be seen by selected few people, let us accept the fact. In the mass education, in the mass schooling, it is not possible to dream this also. But in the small oasis of the knowledge, small oasis of the quality, like your school, you can dream these types of the things. So you are working for the IIT exam, fine. But those who are interested in the pure science, you also nurture these types of students. Because one thing is very clear, is applied knowledge is necessary for the society. But there is a need for the human being to update the applied knowledge. Just I have told you that now we have the robotic operations. Suppose no one have worked on this in the research laboratory, whether this will be possible to apply this to the common man now? So applied knowledge is essential, no doubt. Those who are interested in medicine, they should go for doctor. But those who are interested in pure science, those who want to add some percentage of knowledge of their trade, they should work accordingly and so on. I think some of you may dream this also. 100% result is no doubt a great achievement, and continuous for the 8 years, it is a great achievement. But also after few years, let him, Bipinji must say that I have one scientist who is known and recognized throughout the world for his contributions in the field of his knowledge and so on. So you select any, because while distributing the prizes, I have seen the very good combinations. You have toppers in the Marathi and IT. This is a great achievement. Because someone may be topper in the IT and someone may be topper in the Marathi. But today and tomorrow, the whole global society needs these types of interdisciplinary knowledge. So those who are toppers in IT, I am sure they will go for the IT further education. But don't forget, in the future, when you will have certain level of achievement in the branch, that you are also topper in the Marathi. And now it is your responsibility to decide to apply the Marathi for IT applications.
See, there are a lot of good things suggested in the ancient Indian knowledge bank. But that is everything is in the Sanskrit. You have the Sanskrit in the school. But now the modern medicine science needs the proofs. But those who know the modern medicine science, they don't know the Sanskrit. Because their Sanskrit is adoptional. Now the society needs the knowledge in the Sanskrit about the medicine, about the science, must be found out and must be translated in the modern knowledge form which is applicable in the field of medicine. But for this purpose you need the expertise in the Sanskrit as well as in the physics. Similarly, you have the, you score the 100 marks in the IT and you score the 100 marks in Marathi, fine. Now in the future it is your job. And how the IT, because I am sure after 5 years or 10 years even the illiterate person has to use the IT. Why 10 years? Now today you go to, on any roadside, those who are working, laborers who are working on the highway, most of them are, they are illiterate, you will find they are the mobile. I have one always question with them, I want to share with you. How the illiterate person remember the numbers? Point of question number one. How he know the operation theory, which button to press to start the mobile, then feed the number, how to receive the mobile? So someone of you must discuss with these people how they go for that, how they perform the operation correctly, and how they remember this number belongs to this particular person. Is it not interesting? It means what we call in the computer, it is a customization, they have done their own. Mobile is the one technique, they don't know that, but they know the application part, and while doing, applying it, they have done a suitable method. You can say they have discovered the suitable method which will be easy for them to operate. Is it not the way, it is not a problem for small research, it is not a small problem for the project. Likewise, your expertise, you must be, make it little bit lower. And the whole world which is traveling, which needs the competitive, little bit competitive age is there. You create your own space and then you will find it. The whole world will appreciate you and they will accept you, and most important thing in the tomorrow's world, that they will invite you. Your appreciation is very easy. No, for some people it is also difficult. They don't like to say good, spade as a spade. But appreciation is easy. But to invite you means they accept you have something different, and that different type of knowledge you have to develop, you have to collect in the nearby future. I'm sure, before I conclude, I will say congratulate to all the teachers. You are doing the most work. Because I always feel, suppose this Bipin and his colleagues, they have not started this school. Imagine, just as an illustration, if they have not started this school, how the students may have gone for JEE and all that sort of exams? Where they have the scope to show their meritorious standards? And what is the scope for Jadhkar and Bhosle to go for CBSC 10th and 12th exam? So visionary management, upgrading regularly is useful for you, because today we need a hybrid management. To run the educational institutions on the quality basis is always challenging. Because once 100% result means teachers, administrators and management relax. We have done this for last 8 years. Fine. But you have to do this next year also. And what should be your benchmark? This year you have not all the students in the 60% or 70% or 80% and above. One or two may be less. Next year your benchmark will be all students above 80%. Suppose next year
all students have 80%, fine. What is your benchmark? 80% is less. Now let us try for 85%. For quality, infinity is end. Even if you have all the students have gained 100% mark, I will give you one or two standard more. Quality, infinity is end. And this type of upgradation, these types of the vision, these types of the planning, and this type of administration and management, you have to perform. Because you have taken voluntarily the responsibility of running the quality school. But otherwise, I think when speaking, he says, we were wrong. And when we come out, it is due to the teachers and the parents and the school. This is a good thing. But I expect something more. In the era of computerization, what is the rule? Garbage in, garbage out. But I expect in the Rotary School, garbage in, quality product out. That is the real challenge. And remember, those who are competent, they will accept the challenge. And society will also expect from those who are competent. Society will not expect this from Jilla Parishad School or Corporation School or Municipality School. What? The teachers are also working there. But they are working in a particular frame. And here the whole thing is the frame with the quality and so on. So let us pledge for the improvement and endless improvement. And all dear student friends, I convey you best wishes. In future you reach the height where you want to reach. I will not say that you will go for top. That you have to decide. Because now you have sufficiently grown up. So where you want to reach, you reach the height. And from that point, see the school once again. You will have the very memorable memories here. And that will give you the more joy and so on. Let us pray Almighty that you will reach that height with the best health, best physique, and best human being on the earth. Thank you.
You all are mesmerized. I was observing all that everyone was listening with patience and everything whatever you shared, that some things I will repeat, that is difference between clever and intelligence. So our students will prefer the things which you have given suggestions. And while listening that, I remember one poem, that is Road Not Taken by famous poet Robert Frost. And in that also same thing it is said that you have to choose the path which is not chosen by the others and new things. So for all that valuable guidance, suggestions you have given to our students will make our students' future more brighter than now. Thank you very much, sir, for your guidance. Now I request Honorable SMC Chairman Dr. Rajit sir.
जे यश या शाळेने संपादन केलेलं आहे त्या यशामागचं किंवा त्यांच्या टीम लीडर्स आहेत भूमिका पटेल मॅडम, त्यांना आपण गौरव करूया. मी डॉक्टर सुभाष देवसेना विनंती करतो की भूमिका पटेल मॅडम यांचं कौतुक आणि त्यांचं सत्कार करायचं. खरोखर खूप छान मार्गदर्शक आहे, खूप छान गाणं आहे आणि खूप कमी वयामध्ये एक चांगलं अचीवमेंट त्यांनी केलेलं आहे आणि खूप चांगलं कॉम्पिटिशन आहे. थँक्यू, थँक्यू मॅडम.
थँक यू सर. विजन अँड डेडिकेशन ओनली लीडर्स कॅन विज्युअलाइज. So, thank you, madam. Now, I would request my colleague, V sir, to proceed further. All good things come to an end. As we are approaching
approached the culmination of today's program, I take this opportunity to thank all those who have made this program a grand success. On behalf of our school, I would like to express our gratitude to our today's chief guest, Honorable Professor Dr. Subhash Dev sir, for inspiring our students with his precious words. I request our chairman, Mr. Bipindana Patne sir, to offer thanks letter to Honorable Dr. Subhash Dev sir. Also, I extend my vote of thanks to our guest of honor, Mr. Gangaram Idathe sir, for spending his precious time with us and guiding our student. Once again, I request our chairman, Mr. Bipindana Patne sir, to offer thanks letter to Honorable Idathe sir. I would take this opportunity to say thanks to our guest, Mr. Nitin Mehta sir, for motivating our student with his valuable speech. I request Patne sir to offer thanks letter. I further say thanks to Honorable Professor Rajendra Mehta sir for appreciating our students. I request Bipindana Patne sir to offer thanks later. I also give a big thanks to Honorable Mr. Madhukar Mehta sir. Also, I will say thanks to Honorable Mr. Arjun Jadhav sir. Thank you, sir. Also, I would say thanks to Rotarian Madhav Bhandari sir for attending this program and spending precious time with us. Also, I would say thanks to our chairman, Mr. Bipindana Patne sir, and SMC chairman, Dr. Ajit Bhosle sir, for all the encouragement and support they provided. Also, I would say thanks to all reporters of print media and Deep Wahini, as well as all the dear parents. Further, I extend my vote of thanks to our dedicated teaching and non-teaching staff, and also all the students. Once again, congratulations to all the students and teachers, and best of luck for their bright futures. Now, with the permission of our chairman, Mr. Bipindana Patne sir, I declare that this program has come to the end. Thank you. Thank you very much.